This year, the K.U.Leuven team had several project ideas suggested by the team members, but finally settled on the Essencia coli bacterium. Basically, vanillin is produced proportionally to the amount of blue light detected. This in itself is of course not a great feat. That's why we included a feedback mechanism which detects the amount of vanillin in the surroundings and slows down or speeds up production automatically to maintain a desired concentration. So how does that work? Let's ask the team members themselves.
The feedback mechanism consists of two components. The first is the vanillin receptor, which detects the vanillin in the environment. The second one is the key lock anti-key system, which interferes with the production of vanillin.
Now wait, what's a key lock anti-key system?
The blue light receptor produces a substance which allows the vanillin to be produced by the cell. The system can be compared to a key and lock analogy. The key is produced by the blue light receptor, and the vanillin production is preceded by a lock. The key fits in the lock, and thereby the vanillin production is activated. So now, this is the part where the vanillin receptor has to come in. When it senses a lot of vanillin in the environment, the production has to be slowed down. It does this by producing an anti-key. The anti-key will combine with the key. In this way, the key, which is the activation for the vanillin production, isn't available anymore.
That sounds wonderful! So how do you go about and build all of this?
Because working with biological parts is a time-consuming and tedious process, we had to eliminate all our fatal flaws from our design, previous from our work in the lab. Therefore, we constructed a mathematical model of all different subcomponents of our system. The blue light sensor, the key anti-key lock system, the vanillin synthesis and the vanillin receptor. When all the different subcomponents were tested, we created an integrated model of the system and simulation showed the system could work. Our work in the lab could begin.
A blue light receptor, vanillin production, vanillin receptor and a key lock anti-key system? That sounds like a lot of work.
It's a lot of work, but we don't have to make all components ourselves. In the parts registry, we can find standard components and all parts built in the previous years. So by reusing some of those parts, we can save a lot of time. But of course, not all components can be found as standard parts in the parts registry, especially those specific to our project. So we have to build them ourselves. Afterwards, we put those parts in the parts registry so that they can be reused in the following years.
Oh, okay. So you are continuing on previous work that was done by the scientific community. So how many components did you manage to get from this registry?
The parts registry contains biobricks for the key lock anti-key system and some for the veneer production. Some subcomponents for the veneer production were provided to us by Dr. Chris Friends from the University of Edinburgh. And we decided to improve the key lock system by creating our own version through GeneArt, a gene sequencing company. The biobricks for the blue light receptor and the veneer production are both completely new.
Let's go into the blue light receptor some more. You mentioned that it was built from scratch. How does this work?
I'll tell you. When the cell is irradiated with blue light, it starts a transcription of what we call the blue gene. How does it work? Usually, the blue light promoter is blocked by YCGE, a repressor. But when the cell senses blue light, it dimerizes YCGF, making an activator. Now this activator can bind YCGE, clearing the promoter. Now transcription of the blue key can start.
Ah, and so now the blue key strand is ready to be used in the vanillin production.
That's right. The vanillin production component consists of 5 conversion stages and is activated by a blue key. The blue key unlocks the strand of RNAs that is used to produce 5 enzymes, SEM8, SEM5, COMT, ECA and FCS. Each of these enzymes is used to convert tyrosine into vanillin. The E. coli cell produces tyrosine on its own. SEM8 converts into picomeric acid, which is then converted into caffeic acid by SEM5. Next, the caffeic acid is converted into ferulic acid by COMT, then ferulic coenzyme A by FCS, and finally into vanillin by ECH. The produced vanillin is then pushed out of the cell into the environment where we can eventually smell it.
And this is where the cell detects the vanillin too?
Yes, through its vanillin receptor. The vanillin receptor consists of two parts, two VIR-A proteins, which will dimerize and autophosphorylate when they sense vanillin. VIR-A will phosphorylate VIR-G, so it will be activated. VIR-G will bind the VIR-B promoter region, so the anti-key can be unlocked and transcribed.
The very same anti-key that fits together with the blue key and neutralizes it?
Exactly. The blue key and anti-key were specially designed and manufactured to fit together. When a blue key encounters an anti-key, they will bind and stop the blue key from reaching the vanillin production subsystem.
And because the blue key doesn't reach the vanillin production subsystem, no vanillin is produced until its concentration drops below a certain point, thus stabilizing the vanillin concentration in the environment. This feedback loop has never been implemented in an iGEM project before. We can say without a doubt that feedback is fundamental in biology and that recreating it synthetically is a major achievement. The K.U.Leuven team salutes you. We hope to see you all in Boston soon.